Hey everyone, it was great meeting you in class. There was something that I didn't have a chance to talk to you about, and I wanted to just show you a quick video because it might be worthwhile in finding the voices of people who identify as this, that, or the other thing, right? So I kind of talked about historic newspapers. So if you go to databases, and you go to databases by type and go to newspapers. This is where you find like the complete run of the New York Times, some traditionally African American as audience papers. But what has happened in the last few years, maybe the past couple decades or so, is we've started to be interested in hearing from people who identify as a particular persona. And so that let me show you how we would do that. And so, if somebody was a soldier in Vietnam and they were like a North Vietnamese regular army, and they immigrated to the United States later and they were interviewed, who they are and having their firsthand account in quotes, if they say something, that's a firsthand account, which is a primary source, even though it's embedded in a secondary source. It's not scholarly, but this is how you can do research and figure out some of that qualitative. And storytelling. So my favorite one is called US News Stream. This is most of the newspapers in the United States, and there's some European big ones too, like and South American ones, Madrid, Mexico City, London, and so forth. You can go in, I've got something going on with Zotero. You can go in and do advanced search, but this doesn't work with metadata. This kind of works with like the full text of the articles, and some of the articles are just like two paragraphs long. So let's look for Vietnamese soldier, not solider. Case doesn't matter, so you don't have to capitalize things. Or NVA soldier. I want to type in solider. What my fingers do? Darn fingers. Also, if it's in the context of the United States and they're talking to somebody, they might give them a label that they wouldn't identify themselves. We talked about this last night. So they might call Viet Cong soldier. And somebody might say, well, okay, I'll interview under that context, but I wouldn't consider myself under that label. Well, I put them in quotes so those keywords stick together, right? Otherwise, they'd be floating all over the place. And I do the or in between because I don't know which keyword I want to use. So I wanted to look at each one in the same search and give me a pile of everything that shows up with any of those. And again, I'm looking in newspapers. Why would this show up in a North American newspaper? Typically, it's somebody revisiting the past. So it might be a politician. It might be somebody who was a soldier. It might be somebody who was on in the French army. It might be somebody who's in the United States Army. It might be so on, so on, and so forth. So, Michigan woman meets Viet Cong soldier involved in husband's death. If you looked in that article, you would look for quote marks and see if anybody said something. And it can be something really minute, like this was a great opportunity to make peace with a country. So let's take a look at that one. Almost all of these are full text. And you see this wire feed, do you know what that means? That means that it is put up on the internet. It used to be like Telegraph or something like that. And then local papers could run this as part of a feature. There we go. Just look for the quote marks. The former soldier. See, he was kind, he this. I want to see if that soldier said something. The people were nice. Oh my gosh, look at that. So this wasn't anything, but somebody said the guide, it's like this is where the person died. So we want to find the voice of somebody who was a soldier. So you would just cruise through these. And look for those quote marks. And you just scan through these articles and look for quotes. Here we go. A Vietnamese soldier remembers. If you ever find this, find it. Let me know, and I can track stuff down if you can't get the full text. Slain Marines, to meet soldier. Vietnamese soldier is grateful to U.S. Former Vietnamese soldier will speak. Ex-Viet Cong soldier recalls experiencing very fierce fighting. Right there. What do you do when you want to dig deeper into these 2,300 results? Here's some tips. On the sorting on the side, this is all of those 2,300 articles, and you can go in by date. So it looks like 2000 to 2009, there was the most activity, people reconciling with their past. You can go by publication title, and you can see, is there what, where do I want to go from? I could also go to location. And let's see if we can find something from Utah. So these are, the location sometimes is where the article was written, but oftentimes it's from the paper that was listed. Let's see, do we have Utah? I haven't done this, so I don't know if it's there. Alabama, Algeria, Australia, oh drat, I don't see Utah. Israel, Italy, Mexico, New Jersey, Poland, nope, okay. You can also search within publications. If you wanted to look at the Salt Lake Tribune, Deseret News, you could do similar searches like this by going back to the main search and searching for publications. But this is something that I wanted to show you. Oh, by the way, ex-Vietnam soldier. Say we wanted to cite this one. Most of these databases have a citation generator. It was very fierce fighting. It looks like this is a vehicle for a presidential candidate. Be that as it may, if you find an article that you want to use, click cite right here, and it'll give you a pretty close approximation of a correct one. In most modern styles, we don't have like this big URL and things like that, but it'll get you that metadata. Okay, thanks. Write to me if you want help. I'm delighted to do so.